Hello, welcome back at the culturelovers.eu channel. Today, I have for you a very interesting guest. He will tell a little bit about his life and the times he lived in Paris. He is from the 3rd century, a century in which the Roman Empire was struggling to keep its power. The Goths were intruding near the Danube. During this same period, the Roman Catholic Church also challenged the classic Roman beliefs. I guess you can say that this made the Roman magistrates a bit nervous. In 245, Pope Fabianus, or as we say in English Pope Fabian, sent 7 bishops to Gaul. Gaul is more or less the area of Europe we call France these days. He hoped, by doing this, to establish his power in the church and convert the Gauls to Christianity. Among these bishops is our guest today. It is Saint Dionysius, or Saint Denis as we say in English. So, let me welcome Saint Denis to the show. Saint Denis, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Don Quixote. It is a great honor for me to speak a bit about my life on culturelovers.eu. It was not easy for me to decide to do this. I want to stay true to the facts, and my memory is not as good as it was 1800 years ago. In the end, after a little research on Wikipedia, I have reconstructed the most significant facts about my life. I currently feel confident enough that I can share them with your audience. So, as Don Quixote shared with you already, I was sent by Pope Fabian to go to Lutetia to convert the people there. Lutetia is called Paris at the moment. I could sell the people of Lutetia eternal life, so I guess that was a pretty good offer during those days of misery. At that time, life was not too wonderful, disease and peril were constantly lurking in the shadows. So, I went from Rome to Lutetia, partly by foot, and partly by horseback. It was quite a journey to travel 1,400 kilometers. When I arrived, I immediately started my work. I built a little wooden church on the island of the city, right at the spot where you find the Notre Dame these days. And in that little church, I started to baptize the Gauls. Although I am not sure why they converted so easily, I was successful. Quite a number of them were baptized at my church. During the early days of 250, something terrible happened. The new Roman Emperor Decius wanted to make sure that his subordinates were loyal to him. He felt that both the Goths and the Christians were putting that in doubt. He issued an edict that stated that all subordinates had to make a sacrifice on behalf of the emperor to the Roman gods in front of a committee of magistrates. If people refused to do that, they were either tortured or killed. You can imagine, that edict from Decius was not good for my work. It was a real pity, to say the least. Lutetia was not, by being 1,400 kilometers away, safe from this verdict. Many Christians were persecuted, tortured, and killed. I am afraid I was one of the first. They brought me to the Mount of Mars, just north of Lutetia. I understand that you refer to the place as Montmartre these days, the Mount of the Martyrs. At this 130-meter high hill, they just chopped off my head. As you can imagine, I was not too happy with that. I also was not happy to have my bones end up at this gruesome place. So, as the legend says, I decided to pick up my head and walk for about 7 kilometers north to Catoliacum. It is in this village where I accepted my fate. Catoliacum is currently named after me. It's called Saint Denis. I guess it is now too clear to you why they depict me as a so-called cephalophore or head carrier. Several other saints are also depicted in this way, including Saint Aphrodisius, Saint Ginez, and Saint Gemello. As I am not familiar with their stories, do not assume that a statue always depicts me when it is a head carrier. So, what has happened since? I have become saint, patron saint of the French people and one of the patron saints of Paris, and I am now good for just about anything, from, you're kidding, headaches to diabolical possession. Leaves me thanking you for listening to my story. I hope it will inspire you walking down the streets of Paris, from the Notre Dame, to Montmartre, and maybe even up to Saint Denis. Enjoy life, I would say. I'll hand now the microphone back to Don Quixote.
Thank you, Saint Denis. That was an intriguing story. I would have hoped it had a better ending, but I suppose that is not to be expected from a head carrier. I am sure that the story has inspired the patrons of this channel to plan for a walk from the Notre Dame to Saint Denis. Anyway, back to culturelovers.eu. You can expect more of these short stories by guest speakers on this channel. Our current goal is to get Eleanor of Aquitaine and Alphonse X to participate in future episodes, so that we can learn about their interesting lives. Okay, that was it for this week. I hope you enjoyed it, and subscribe to our channel. See you again next week.